I hope you're all good. I'm going to start the video without my respirator on. Just thought it would be a bit different. And then just voice over when I have my respirator on. So these have been sitting on my shelf for months. All beautiful colours, all nicely resined. But I got a message a couple of weeks ago from a lady, a really lovely lady, asking if I could donate any raffle prizes for a charity. I will name the charity in my description when I put my video up. It's a very rare charity. So this is me. I've waited till later on in the evening because it's been boiling hot all over the UK and usually up here in Scotland as well. So what I'm going to do is these need to have a top coat put on them, just so I know they're all good, and they're all good for heat proof for your cups of coffee and tea and maybe your glasses of wine or your cold beverages. I don't often get a chance to make these very much. I haven't had a lot of time this year to make any of these, and this was just me testing out some colours. Excuse me. So hold on 2 seconds, I will come back to you. Hey, that's me back again. Sorry guys, that's the only thing with filming on my phone. Excuse me, I have to put it on do not disturb an aeroplane mode so nobody can therefore ring me, and usually it comes through on my iPad. So yes, that's dealt with. Anyway, so today we're going to be, as I said, tonight, now that it's a bit cooler, going to get these flood coated. So I'm going to be using Just For Use Rebel Glitters white ignition dust, because we can't not have that extra sparkle to finish these and just make them complete. No set of coasters is complete without some bling and some sparkle. So I'm going to get this all mixed up and I will be back shortly, and obviously my voiceover will begin. Speak to you soon, guys. Hey guys, back again. This is me doing the voiceover part. That's me with my respirator on, safety first, respirator, goggles, well ventilated area, good intake of air, good outtake. You know me, safety first. I still don't have long sleeves on, my bad. You could tell me off in the comments. So I got all my resin mixed up. It's boiling hot, so I just took my time with the resin. It was extra runny. Oh, I'm so sorry guys. Excuse me. It's very late. Wanted to wait till it cooled down. Anyway, as I was saying earlier, I'm using Just For You Online UK's new white ignition dust. There it is there. Super sparkly. Super amazing. So you can use it in anything. This is the second time I've used it, and I'm using it to do a top coat on these coasters. I just thought they needed a little bit of extra pizzazz, and the ignition dust is amazing. So as you can see, I only put a tiny amount in for a flood coat, top coat, or for whatever. Do you know what? You can use as much or as little as you want. I do add some more because I thought there was
there was enough, there just wasn't enough. So yeah, I added more than enough, studding all around the sides, did all the important stuff when I was mixing it together. So anyway, as I said at the start, I would put the information in the description. I'll just quickly run over it now, as I'm away to pour the resin on, and you know all that boring stuff. Pour it on, spread it about, make sure all your coasters are covered. So a few weeks ago, I was asked if I, well, actually, I wasn't really asked. A completely different set of circumstances. Somebody's doing a charity auction for heart disease. So I had a piece sitting wrapped up. I'm trying to sort out a website. So I have a different platform for selling my own work. I really would like a website to do so. So I've had stuff sitting there. I haven't really pushed for sale, you know, in between commissions. Excuse me, guys. So it was, I made it ages ago. It was my geode and steampunk purple heart. It was titled A Still Heart. Obviously for, you know, I donated that. That's going to be an auction piece, to go into the auction for the raising money for heart disease, Rich Heart Foundation, which is very close to my own heart, but I won't go into that just now. So that was good deed. I'd like to think that was good deed number one. Excuse me, guys. And then a few days ago, I had someone else contacting me, that my sister knows, a friend, asking if I had anything that I could donate for raffle prizes. And this is for the Oliver Bosch appeal. It's supported by the Tayside Deaf Hub. I'll not go into too much detail about it, but obviously you can go and Google it. The problem with Oliver's condition or conditions is that there is so few people with some of the things he has. He also suffers from Golden Heart Syndrome, and there's not very many people with it, so it doesn't get a charity status. This is why the Tayside Deaf Hub got involved. So that's a little bit of background information. I always feel like it's important, you know, to say. So these are my donation for a raffle prize. They've been, as I said, they've been sitting on my shelves, gathering dust. I hadn't really had any plans for them. Excuse me. So I really wanted to, you know, I've got loads of other things sitting there. I have a specific time limit to get them heat-proofed, weather's been hit and miss. So I thought I'll get it done. I have a couple of weeks, then I can test them and make sure they're all good to go. I liked, you know, it's nice to be able to help. It really is, you know. And if I could do it, I had a couple of other coasters, I heat tested them today, and they held up for the most part. Couple of teensy-weensy marks, just because they'd been done with pigments, and obviously that it messes about with the integrity of the resin when you're adding loads of things like, excuse me, colour, pigment, mica, glitter. It all changes the genetic makeup of your resin. So, you know, that's why people always do a flood coat on any piece of art or any piece of functional art, because then you're just putting the resin on and you're not adding any extra. I know I only added a tiny amount of ignition dust, which wouldn't have had any bearing on the outcome of the flood coat. Excuse me, guys. I say that a lot. I'm going to have to think of a new word. 2 seconds. So, resin is on. This is just me going around the sides. Obviously, because I waited till later on in the day, I didn't have my excellent reflection from the window to make sure that every single piece of the coaster was covered. So I truly, I wouldn't say I struggled. I used my light. I used my strip light, and I did kneel down and look at them and thought, when I finished filming, I had to, I always went round corners and everything. Very pernickety. It all have to be perfect, and because I didn't mix it like a maniac really vigorously, there was really hardly any bubbles. I was quite surprised. Normally, when you're not meant to mix fast, normally I'm always in a hurry and I mix the resin quickly, but as I said, I just took my time tonight because it's too hot. It's too hot to rush around. So it's cooled down a bit now, but we shall see. It's still very, very humid. Not great conditions for doing resin, as most of you know. Humidity is a pain in the neck for doing resin work. Heat and humidity. A lot of people could probably relate to that. So yes, this was me off camera. I'll be kneeling at the side looking, thinking, is that a bit covered? Here we go. I thought, you know what, I can't see. I'm going to use my strip light. So this was just me checking. I would like to get a new light. Oh, so sorry guys. I'd like to get a round light or a bigger light or just a better light. This light's really good. It's I think it's called the Daylight. I got it from Hobbycraft and it's excellent. Obviously have the room light, my studio space, and this, and I have been meaning to invest in something like the big guns, something better, something, you know, just the business. It would help. It would really, really help. But I'll save all my pennies and get something eventually. So yeah, I'm just blathering away now because I'd have to go around the edges again. Just checking my timer. Got cut off there for a minute because I was trying to increase the brightness on my phone. There's another thing I need to save up for. Proper filming and editing equipment. Equipment. Can't even talk now. It's so late. I'm tired. Equipment. We'll get there. We'll get there in the end. It's not my main focus. I like to do my videos for you guys. Obviously, focusing on my work is key. I'm in the middle of a commission just now. I have free rein to film it and whatnot, but I just haven't had a minute. It's a mixed media piece with, which started off with, it's 16¾ by 16¾ inches canvas, with some texture, some resin, quite texture is all up in the one part, and then there's going to be resin of various colours. So we'll see if I have time, because I have been asked to do another commission, so I might have to squeeze them both in together. If I have time, I will try and film some of it, but you know how difficult it is to find time. I really wouldn't mind doing a live as well at some point. I probably regret saying that. Yeah, let's do a live. Just throw myself in at the deep end. Yeah, just torching. Even though there wasn't a lot of bubbles, I still wanted to make sure there was nothing. And I shook everything off before I covered them. But knowing my luck, I bet you any money I'll go in tomorrow and there'll be a hair. Please pray for me. Pray there isn't a hair, because I will have a meltdown, because I am not doing another flood coat. We'll just say on the thing that they have natural fibres in them. I put that on a post. Somebody put that on a post once, and someone else had a meltdown about it. But yeah, I'm joking. I would never leave a natural fibre in the coating of the resin. But some people, I know you feel my pain. I know you do. You think they're perfect, and you go and check the next day. You honestly, I worry myself all night, praying that no tiny hair got in there, no cat hair, no dog hair, and it's a closed off room. And they do not get allowed in there, so there shouldn't be these things, but there always is. They manage to escape, they find their way into that space, and they just defeat me all the time. I hope everybody's good wherever you all are. I know it's been really warm all over the UK and in America. My auntie lives in America, she's in Pennsylvania. It's been boiling everywhere, which I shouldn't really complain, because I'm in Scotland. It's not often as warm as it has been, but then there's comfortable warm and comfortable sun, and then there's very uncomfortable warm. As I said earlier, it has cooled down a little bit. Thank the Lord. So I'm just doing the final touches. This is going up on my YouTube channel, and then I will be back on to chop it down to its 10 minutes for my IGTV and my Facebook. So I hope you all enjoyed, guys. Please like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell for future notifications. I really appreciate everybody's support, and I will try and get on with more content as soon as I get a minute. So I hope you all take care wherever you are. Stay well hydrated, plenty of sun cream, and just be kind to yourselves. Look after yourselves. Anyway, guys, I will get going, and I will catch you all on the next one. Bye.